Hello everyone, welcome back. Today we will be working with a brand that it's not so common for everyone. It's a brand that started in Germany and now it's made in Budapest. The name of the brand is Heinrich Dinkelacker, I think that's how you pronounce it. And this model is a Buda, full Brogue Buda. It has a Goisier Norwegian Welt. As you can see, it's very interesting to the eyes, very eye appealing. These hands, these shoes are hand welted. And well, they have seen better days. I mistreated them a lot, even though they are among my favorite. I have neglected them, but then I have used them severely. So I thought it would be an interesting project to bring into the table. So these shoes are, and I have to be upfront about it, these shoes are not for everyone. They are rather voluminous, they're really chunky, but they have their own appeal. I find them really different, yet really interesting. But again, these are not a shoe for everyone. They are quite big and they are quite heavy. So for a shoe that is not an actual work boot, yes, they are. They're quite something. Because they are Brogue, I will, with a toothpick, go and try and clean as much as I can each of these Brogue decorations. This is a bit laborious, but it needs to be done anyway. These are areas where grime and dust and dirt accumulates, also waxes. But I have to be sincere that I have not waxed these shoes that much. Like I said, these are one of my favorite shoes, but I wear them for stuff that I shouldn't be wearing them, most likely to work. Even though I do have some specific work boots, but I rather enjoy them. They're quite comfortable. And it all started one day that I needed to do some yard work, and I didn't have my work boots close by, and I was wearing these shoes. So I thought, well, let's try and see if their construction is really what they claim it to be, and sure enough, they held up to the task, and ever since I have just had them to work around the house, which in retrospective, maybe I shouldn't have done that. They are, like I said, one of my favorite shoes. It is what it is. Anyhow, they are about to be ready to be retouched by a cobbler. But because they have this hand welt and this goisier welt, I think I might have to send them back to the original manufacturer. So I'll approach them and ask about what can be done, because I don't know if everyone, if any cobbler actually deals with this kind of welt. So with the toothpick, you go ahead and you clean this Roguing. Please use a toothbrush. Don't use anything metallic because it might be too much for the skin. You may rip it. Toothbrush, a toothpick is much, it's much more gentle. So that's what I would recommend to use. Again, this is not strictly necessary, but if you want to make something, if you want to work on something, you try to do it to the best of your capacities. And I think it's something that's worth doing. It's worth doing the right way. So. Keep track of the areas that you've worked on. So you don't duplicate your efforts. So let's try and be as methodical as possible. Anyway, again, don't take this too seriously because it's supposed to be done, in my case, for fun and relaxation. And I hope in your case as well. If you do this for a living, then well, that's a different story, but I still think that it brings a lot of gratification, the fact that you see something start in one condition and then finish in a different one that most likely should be from worse to better. These areas are where you have to be careful because these medallions are hard to keep track. Where have you actually already worked on? So be patient and yeah, grind at it. Really neglected then. Jesus. Now I do feel bad about being a bad owner of shoes. Maybe I pampered my shoes too much. Yeah. Maybe I do. Now, today, I could use a paste or cream cleaner, like the pure polish, but because there's so much Brogue in here, I think I'd much prefer to go with the liquid cleaner. That way there's nothing left behind. Because the liquid obviously will evaporate. So I think I might use the boot black double face lotion to clean the shoes. Yeah, I think that's the route I'll take. Wow. I feel so irresponsible in the condition that these shoes are. The fact that I use them to work would mean that maybe I should also take the extra step to properly care for them so that they last longer. Yeah, now I feel irresponsible. Sorry if I'm speaking my mind here. Okay, I think they're looking a lot better. Might not be 100%, but a lot better. Okay, let's switch toothpick and it's the same thing on the other one. The reason why I switch toothpick is because there was already dirt on the other one. I don't want to bring grime and whatnot from one shoe to the other. Could have just kept on using the same one, but if you're trying to clean, I think that that defeats the purpose. Just my opinion anyway. It's almost Halloween here. I don't know when I will be done with this, and I don't know when I will release the actual video, but by the time I'm doing this, I'm almost in Halloween 2020, which is going to be interesting given the global current situation. I hope that you're still keeping safe, and if you can avoid large groups of people, please do so. Slow down this spreading. Perhaps not only so much for you, in case you're not in that risk population, but for everyone else that is. I'm sure that we all have relatives that might be in that population that is high risk. So please take care of yourself. Not only for you, but for the ones that you care for. I also want to share that I just finished a, well, it's not that I finished, I just received in the mail a pair of shoes that I sent to Hancor. And he's a patina artist in New York. I know a lot of other channels do their own patinas, but I'm not proficient enough to attempt to do the one on video. And it's also a very lengthy process, and my videos are already long as they are. So, anyhow, what I did is that I chose a pair of black shoes. Very similar to this in terms of the broguing, and they are long wind tips. And I asked Greg if he could do something with them. Now, bear in mind that black is a very aggressive color when it comes to dyeing. So I was not expecting for him to actually give me a positive response about, yes, we can do something, but interesting enough, he told me, yeah, sure, we can work with those. And I was pleasantly surprised. So I told him, hey, Greg, okay, so I'll be sending the shoes. And I think from the moment I sent them to the moment I got them back, being close to a month or so. And I'm pretty sure he's busy because he also works directly with the shoes from Justin Fitzpatrick. So I'm pretty sure he's quite a busy guy, but I was impressed by the turnaround time. I also did a small video on that. So I recorded the shoes before, and I will make a video of the shoes after. Again, I did that out of my own expenses, not that I'm promoting Rick's business. I think he already has more traction than I do anyway. I did it because, well, I've commented on previous videos that sometimes it'd be a good idea to have someone else shine your shoes. A pro, if you may. They have more tools, they have more know-how. So I apply the same logic. If I wanted to have a patina shoe, very particular color, then why not rely on someone that does that for a living, someone that is an expert on the topic? Can I learn? Sure. Have I tried? Yes. But this was a pair of brand new shoes that I did not wear that often because they were black, so when I needed a black shoe, I tended to gravitate to something else. So I asked him if something could be done, and I knew that I wanted something in the shades of gray, which I hope was helpful as well for him. Stripping all that black must have been painful. And he was really good. He was really communicative about the process. And I asked him halfway through, like, hey, how are the shoes going? And he said that he had stripped most of the color out. When I asked him for a picture, and he was hesitant, he told me, well, you know, don't panic. Apparently people get freaked out when they see the process halfway through, when they see the actual leather being stripped. I know what to expect because, like I said, I have done it before myself, so I had an idea about what I was going to receive in terms of pictures, and sure enough, I was surprised though by the amount of pigment that he was able to remove. And he was really creative about that because they were Brogue. They are Brogue, sorry. The areas where the shoe has to Brogue in, I'm pretty sure it was hectic and complicated to remove the color. So those were the areas where he also, I think, used a navy blue pigment that I wanted for the shoe. So they are navy blue and gray. One of these days we'll do a video about that. I don't know in which order I'll publish them, but if that came first, then that's the story behind the shoe. If this came first, then you should look forward to that too. Okay. You could always do this also with this clean up the broguing with maybe like a cotton swab or something. Now we will go ahead and do some cleaning. Again, I think in this case it makes more sense to use a liquid cleaner as opposed to a paste. Now this is also a conditioner, so just like the pure polish cleaner conditioner, and this is also a conditioner. So it helps you clean, remove dirt and grime, but it also helps clean. What I'm trying to do is remove basically dirt from the uppers. So yeah, maybe the next video will be related to the overall review about a resoling, reconditioning of the shoe by a manufacturer. So now I'm gonna add some this cleaner here to the shoe, to the cloth. And because this is also thread, I need to make sure that I get in there and clean it as much as I can. Which I think now you can appreciate why I was using more of a liquid cleaner. I don't think a paste would have gone deep into the welt there. To me, it makes more sense to try and use a liquid one. Looking better already. And I'm sorry that you have to see this. It's not what I intended for these shoes when I got them, but again for the uppers. I had to remove my sweater, sorry, but that was kind of hot around here. This stage, what we need to do is carry on with the treatments. The next step is going to be conditioning the insoles of the shoes. The insoles of these shoes are also made out of leather, so I might as well treat them. So I also changed the angle of the camera. I hope that offers a better view of what's going on with the shoe. Is it important to condition the insoles of the shoe? I would say most definitely, because they are part of the structure of the shoe. And it is also an area where your feet come in contact with the shoe. So you don't want to have rips and tears that become uncomfortable for the shoe to wear. And remember, no matter how pretty the shoes are, if they are not comfortable, you won't wear them. So, priority number one, keep the shoes healthy so that they remain being comfortable. Don't worry if you feel like you're being a little bit heavy with the applications of moisturizers and creams. At least in the insoles, that's not too much of a deal. And with certain leathers, they are a bit more forgiving than others. I would say though that if you have to be cautious of one leather, that's gonna be shell cordovan. Does not do well with over conditioning, over moisturizing. Okay, well that's it's drying. Let's off the shoe. And make sure that it is looking a little more presentable. Overall, the more important aspect of the shoe is for you to wear them. And they develop their own personality. Sometimes these creases over here, they just add a little bit of their own character, if you make each shoe. So do not worry too much about that. Okay. At this stage, I will try a lighter color just in case. So I'm going to start applying a layer of cream in the color number 03, which is light brown. Make sure that I always start spreading on the surfaces that are not broke. That way you avoid clogging those little perforations on the leather. But do make sure that you apply enough cream as to cover everything. It's a little bit of a complication there because you want to apply enough but not too much. Now if at any point you feel like you're applying a little bit too much, then grab yourself a little brush and immediately remove the excess. Just like that. If not, you're gonna just keep on building on those areas, and then that creates the clogging of the broguing, which you don't want to have. Sorry. It would be easier also just to use the little brush to apply the cream throughout the whole surface of the shoe. Personally, I prefer to use my hands. That way I can feel the skin. And if it's taking the cream a little bit better. Plus, it allows me also a higher degree of control. And I also save product because, not that I'm stingy, but you don't want to have too much on there. You just want to have the right amount. Now at this stage, I'll give it a pass with the brush to ensure that there is no excess cream in any of the areas. Also, if there is an excess, by using the brush, I'll redistribute the cream a little bit more uniformly. Let's see. Yes. Already dry. Proceed again to put the shoe tree on. And come with the cream. Now for this pair, I have to be straightforward. I don't think I need to apply a mirror shine. I don't think it's something that is necessary for this particular pair. They detonated a lot of TLC. Honestly, they're getting close to the point where I might need to have a professional cobbler work on the heels and the soles. So I think in this case, I'll just bypass the mirror shine. Sorry if you're looking forward to that. I don't think it's gonna happen on this one right now. I am not so happy with how the color is looking. So I'll add a tad of cognac on certain areas of the shoe, especially the toe cap areas, to make it look a little bit more rich. Small amounts, nothing too crazy. So here in the heel area as well, just to add a touch of tad dimension to the shoe. Looks better. Evidently, by having a clearer layer of cream before, less of this dark pigment is going to be absorbed into the leather. Don't get me wrong, there will be some transfer of color, but it's not as much because there was an initial layer of the light brown before. Okay, I think that's looking good enough. I'll let the cream do its thing, and in the meanwhile, I use that same brush to treat this massive welt. You can see the welt is coming undone here, and that is another reason why I need to have a professional look at them. Also, you can see that the sole is coming apart. This is a two-layer sole, and it also has a toppy. So this is leather, this is rubber toppy. Been trying to maximize the amount of wear out of the shoe, but I think it's about time. Which is why I'm not doing a mirror shine. So I don't think it's worth adding a mirror shine, because then it's gonna be more laborious for the cobbler to remove it. Okay, using a cloth here, I'll remove any excess cream so that there is less transfer to the brush. Okay, let's change the spot here. This is how it starts. this is how it's looking after it. You can definitely see that there's some color transfer there. Okay. Now I chose neutral wax because the breeding here in the Welt has different colors. There is brown and there is black, so I don't want to change the color of the original Welt. I don't know if that is your consensus, but I think they're looking better already. Okay. Let us put a pair of laces and work with some wax, and I think they'll be done. Lacing here a little bit. Go with a more traditional and simple lacing system. Nothing too complicated. But since we are in the process of exploring, let's see what happens if we go with a little bit more of a show off lacing system. Over and under. fantastic. Over and under. Which one do you think? I think I prefer this one. So let us redo the whole lacing. Could have gone with parallel bars, but there are not too many. Lace holes. I don't think it's worth it. If it had 4 or 5, maybe. But I think this is good enough. Yes, it's rather pedestrian, but I think I like it. I use some Saphir. This is light brown. Again, start in the area of the shoe on which there is no broguing, so that you don't end up accumulating too much in the perforations. We don't have excess wax there. Jeez, I don't know what's wrong with me. Make sure you add a first layer of wax to the whole shoe so as to protect it. I think I'll be contacting Steve at Beatles to see if he'd be interested in taking this project. We'll see. But I'm definitely certain that they need some love. That is a certainty. Let's add a couple more layers of wax. Toe cap and the heel area. Make sure it's spread really thin. What do you think of this style of shoe? Is it too chunky for you? Like I said, this is not a shoe for everyone's taste, but I find it rather good looking. It definitely adds to the shoe the method construction. This is made by hand, according to what I understand anyway. You can see that there's already some accumulation there. Wax, which is why one has to be careful. Real nice.
Okay. Let's cover this and now let's treat the sauce. Some dark brown for the edge here. Make sure everything, this is leather, so I mean not all of it, because the top is rubber and also the heel is rubber, but originally there was a lot of leather here, not so much now. Draw me to these shoes. It's the overall shape of it. They're massive. It's like a those traditional vintage floor shimes, but on steroids. That's one way I would describe it. I don't think I'd be off the mark. So we are almost finishing this pair, and I think they do look a lot better. Let me get some water. And I did say I was not going to add a mirror shine, and I'm not, but I will definitely add a little higher shine on the toe cap. Again, because I placed a lighter color before this dark brown wax, I think there shouldn't be too much of a color transfer. Then again, these shoes are almost ready for a resole, so if that is the case, they might also get a new dye. Yes. Okay. Now, contrary to other times today, because I'm not pursuing a mirror shine, I am just going to use regular water and not water with alcohol for this shine. We're not pursuing a mirror shine. We're just adding a small pop to the cold cut berry. Same thing here for the heel. The idea is always to attract the eye in those areas that you want the eye to look. Nice already. I don't know where the camera is. I hope it's capturing this area properly. I hope so. Okay. Let's switch gears here. Some moisture, some wax. For whatever reason, I always feel like the second shoe always goes faster than the first one. Maybe it's just my perception, but that's how I feel sometimes. Yes, sir. Now, be careful when you do a mirror shine on a broad pair of shoes. If water goes into those perforations and it's an excessive amount, you will end up with wet spots and you will not be able to develop a mirror shine in those areas. You'll have to wait for that to dry out, which is why I'm trying to be as cautious as possible to not let too much water fall in those perforations of the broken areas. Yes, you can definitely tell that this is catching up faster than this one for whatever reason. The treatments were almost identical. It seems like one shoe. It's taking the shine a little bit better than the other. Why that is, I don't know. Human error, perhaps. And since I'm the human shining the shoes, that means that it was my error, which is fine. Yeah, I think that's good enough for me. Pass here, fix the shoe. Okay. Now let's finish the shoe how we normally do. Sorry. We'll add some water to a brush. Everything gets brushed. Even the areas where we got that high shine with the chamois, everything. Let's repeat the process with its brother. Moisture. And a lot of elbow grease. Let me do one final pass with the chamois. High shine chamois. Where is it? It's over here. Get it straight, get it taut. So, you're acting up on me. There we go. It's a lot better. Now, get some moisture in there. Really, really long strides. See the mirror shine? Nope. But it was not meant to be. It's just meant to be a high shine. Same here for the soles. We're done. Yes, and just like that, we went from A to B with these shoes. We conditioned them, cleaned them, and added a little bit of wax. They're ready to go, but I think that they definitely need to see a color real soon. Thank you very much. I hope this creates value to you. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have not done so, please like and subscribe, share it with your friends, and I'll see you next time. Have a good day.